Hello guys, so we have the Tea Protocol Airdrop eligibility checker. If you found this airdrop, I remember sharing it last year and I made a video about it on this YouTube channel. So if you found it, now you can check if you are eligible or not. Remember, this was a test net and we did a couple of tasks. So if you are eligible, you have to also complete your Zkpass verification. So now here is it. I'll drop the checker link and the Zkpass link in the description box of this video, so you can check. When you click on the checker link, you sign up, sign in using your email that you use to sign up, of course. Then at the top of the page here, you are seeing you are eligible for a Tea airdrop. Navigate to settings and enter your destination wallet address. So the first thing you need to do here is to set your Web3 wallet address. Remember, the wallet that we've been using on this Tea protocol was their own generated wallet. Like, this is a blockchain coin. They are building their own blockchain. So you have to enter your external wallet. So I'll click on these settings. I'll just click on the settings. Then scroll down. You can see Tea wallet address. This was the auto-generated wallet address that we've been using to farm the testnet. Then I can scroll to register airdrop. Airdrop destination eligible. Then register airdrop address. I'll click on that. You're about to specify a personal wallet address where your airdrop will be sent. This is a one-time irreversible action. The address you provide must be a personal wallet you control. Do not submit an address from ITN. You cannot change the wallet address after submission. Hope you are reading. So I've ticked those information. Then I'll click on continue. Then enter the personal wallet address where you want to receive your airdrop. Enter destination OX. So you should be using either MetaMask, OKX. You are using EVM wallet. That's just it. You need an EVM wallet to submit here. So you submit your EVM wallet. So you are seeing destination address submitted. Your airdrop destination address has been successfully registered. They are sending this token. Even though I'm not seeing the quantity I'm giving, or I don't know, they just said I'm eligible. I'm not saying the quantity. So I think they will automatically send it to their to my wallet address. And you can see there is no way to edit. So that's for the wallet address submission. So now let me check the Zkpass verification page. So here you are going to click on this T network. Then you have this page. You are seeing T Sepolia. This T Sepolia is where you'll be able to start the testnet to do the authentication. So you see this network information. We're going to add it to the wallet, and also the testnet phase for this KYC commences today, 31st of March, and it will last till April 20th. So you see, claim test T from the full set, create your T Sepolia account and complete Zkpass KYC. So the minute you click on this T network, you will see this page. So yeah, they said create T testnet what's it called? Faucets. I'll click on this faucet. I want to claim the testnet. So you have to also have an account here. Let me see. Scan to connect and sign in. Let me switch to desktop. Connect with MetaMask extension. Make sure the wallet you are connecting with is the same that you submitted as a wallet destination. If you submit separate wallet, then you are not going to get what you're supposed to get. So are you a developer? Okay, let's settle. Okay, let me just complete this registration. I'll continue with this username is already taken. Okay, let me choose continue with G2. So I can complete the T Sepolia registration here. We are building your account, okay. So this T Sepolia registration is different from the one that you are farming. Click here for network details. It's different from the one that you farm during the their own testnet. This is Sepolia testnet. So I'm gonna add all of these details to MetaMask wallet. There should be a logo to add to MetaMask. Let me click on launch the app. Okay, that means I'm still going to have to add it manually. Oops. I don't want to be adding manually. Let me see if there is any workaround. You should just bring logo to how to MetaMask. I'm not sure there's a workaround there. Okay, looks like we are going to add it manually. And that's... So this is the network information. I'll come to MetaMask. If I start adding it manually now, it will keep on canceling. Let's see. So you click, I'll select add custom network. This one. See. Sepolia. So I'm just going to add the network, then click on save before I can proceed with the testnet. So now I've added the network and as you can see, it's currently under the T Sepolia network. The moment you are on the right network, this page will open. So now I can copy the address and request faucet. Let me copy the T address here. Then request faucet so that we use it as gas for the testnet interaction. Then this is the faucet page. I'll enter the address here. Paste. Confirm capture and click on request forms. It has to verify your capture first. So you see 50T something something. You still click on verify I am a human and click on claim rewards. Remember, in all you do, make sure you are using the same wallet to complete this Sepolia verification, the Sepolia testnet, and also the one you are submitting, like I showed earlier. If you use different wallets, then so I've requested for the faucet here. Yeah? You can see the faucet is now claiming. Okay, transaction successful, and that's it. So now I can come back to the main tax here and click on this. KYC attestation is required in order to be eligible for an airdrop. Navigate to settings and complete attestation. So now I click on that settings from this page here. Then it's bringing out my address automatically. Then I'll click on begin KYC attestation. So I hereby attest that I am not listed on any sanction. Okay, I'll just click on this. I understand that providing false or misleading information in this attestation may result in legal okay. So let me do for Bybit. For block merge, I don't know if we can use the same thing for here because I have my Zkpass extension installed on this device and I use it for block merge. So if they can just verify automatically, okay, let me use a VPN. Let me turn on my VPN. Because I remember doing the same thing for, we use this same Zkpass for the block merge KYC as well. So let's see if I will be able to, let me reload. Just want to be sure. Okay, let's see if it is load. So here is it. I've just logged into my Bybit. I use a VPN. Remember, if you follow my video on block match Zkpass verification like this, I mentioned about this VPN and why it is important for you to use to open Bybit if you are not in a region that you can access Bybit from the web. So here is it. As the pass KYC verification, country is eligible. I'll click on start and let's see. Because I have installed the Zkpass, you do not meet the require. Please check the following criteria. Ensure that you are logged into your primary account. Okay. And this was the same Bybit I used for block match. Let me retry. What's going on? Please check the following criteria. Ensure that you are logged into your primary account. I don't have a secondary account. You have partner with Zkpass, okay, in one supported exchange. So to verify your KYC status, you must have an active account in one of the supported exchanges and use the Zkpass Transgate. Okay, let me click on this Zkpass Transgate and see if it's already not added to my code or is it different from the one I'm having. So I have the Zkpass here already. So am I getting error? Let me try again. I think I should first of all log into Bybit. Let me first of all sign into my Bybit account and make sure that I log into my Bybit instead of going to Zkpass directly. As you see what I just did, I first of all log into my Bybit account firstly. Before coming here to click on the attestation like I clicked earlier, and you can see KYC attestation complete. Now it has been completed. Tell us a bit about yourself. Help us to tailor your custom experience. Okay. Notification email. Add a notification email to configure the email. So the most important thing is that I've linked my wallet and I have completed the attestation, which is the KYC. So I think I'm good. So the email is just secondary, even though I'm going to add it, but let me see from here if I've completed what they asked of me. Okay, claim tea test from Fuset, create your tea account or on Sepolia, complete KYC attestation, support CX. We only receive a zero knowledge proof confirming you have KYC your data. So these are the three main tasks for you to be able to get your airdrop token if you are eligible. So make sure you complete these three main tasks as shown in this video. So guys, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also turn on your notification bell and you'll be notified of my back-to-back updates. Check the link for this testnet guide for the links to participate in this testnet in the description box of this video. You can also join my Telegram community so you don't miss out on any of my back-to-back updates. Check the link to my Telegram channel in the pinned post in the comment section or the description box of this video. See you guys on the next one and bye for now.